Is it rolling?
Yes, it is.
Okay. Good morning all. It's good to see everyone. I wish there were a way that we had seats for everyone, but we'll figure that. I am State Senator James Sanders Jr. I'm the chairman on the Committee on Banks, and this is the Senate Standing Committee on Banks. We had a great year or season last season, and it was last year. Okay, we can do that. We had a great last year, and we're going to have a greater one this time, and especially needed now that we see ourselves in a $6 billion deficit and things of that nature. This committee becomes even more important, where we have to make sure that we get through the situation well. Greetings, sir.
Oh, greetings.
Hello. So, good. I will keep talking as we keep coming in. That's all right. We had a great season, and the season is getting better and better. Good morning, all.
Good morning.
You're
starting to worry.
Like vinegar and water.
So, today we are joined by our superintendent, Linda Lacewell of the Department of Financial Services. But we're going to do just a little different because I want to make sure she knows who's in the room. With the exception of you two, why don't we quickly say who's in here and what district, what part of town, so she at least knows where you are.
Yeah, sure. Senator Tom O'Mara from the Southern Tier Finger Lakes region.
I like it. Great place.
Senator Jim Tedisco, the 49th Senatorial District, 4,000 square miles. I have the county of Hamilton County, Schenectady, Saratoga, Fulton, and Herkimer. Hamilton County, biggest geographic county in the state, 4,000 people.
I like it.
So on a given day, I may shake hands with more bears than people.
There you go. As long as you don't bring them here. I'll let you get your breath, but we're just going around and saying for the superintendents, so she knows who's in the room and what area of New York.
Roxanne Prasad, I represent the 19th Senatorial, and that's the great county of Kings.
Wow. You're the Queen of Kings.
That's true. We'll go here. I like this.
Senator George Borrello from the 57th Senate District, and I represent Chautauqua County, which is where I live, along beautiful Lake Erie, Cattaraugus County, Allegheny County, and eight towns in Livingston County, about the same size as your district as far as miles, and about a 4.5-hour drive from Albany. But great to be here and looking forward to working with you on this committee.
We're going to have fun here.
So, Kevin Thomas, District 6, Mid Nassau County. It's not as big as my Republican colleague. We have more people than bears, or no bears.
We can send you some.
It's a supposed one.
Good morning. This is Kim Bell from the ground floor up. So I'm Senator Spoda from the Bronx, home of the New York Yankees, of course. Home of the Bronx Zoo, the Botanical Gardens.
You have bears.
Yeah.
Bears.
Behind gates, yeah. We know. That's right. We have the most people don't know that we have the most collegiate campuses in the United States of any county.
Wow.
And the most churches. Per square mile of any county.
Amen.
So if anybody's looking for salvation, come back to the Bronx.
Those things don't seem to go hand in hand. But sir.
Yeah, Tim Kennedy, Buffalo, New York. Same home of the only New York State football team.
I know we're all Buffalo.
You know, he doesn't mention the Sabres, does he?
I'll just Neil Breslin from Albany, which is commonly referred to in a historical perspective as the gateway to the West, lawmaker of the Empire State, surpassed in beauty by only Vienna and Paris.
and the Rockaway, which is, everyone knows that. Ms. Lacewell previously served as the chief of staff and counselor to the governor. In that role, she oversaw the executive chamber's operations as well as ethics and law enforcement matters. She also served as special counsel to the Attorney General Cuomo. Been there for a while. Where she oversaw the public pension fund pay-to-play investigation and the out-of-network health insurance investigation, both of which led to nationwide systemic reform. Prior to that, Ms. Lacewell spent 9 years as an assistant U.S. District Attorney for the Eastern District of New York, including 2 years on the Enron Task Force. She also teaches ethics at NYU Law School. Without further ado, I give you Ms. Lacewell. Committee, Ms. Lacewell, Ms. the committee.
Thank you, sir. It's a pleasure to be here. I appreciate the open dialogue that we've had from day one. I appreciate what you bring to the table with your immersion in the issues and your passion for the issues. I am appreciative of the developing relationship with each of you and looking forward to getting to know each of you better and the needs of your constituents as we work together to keep our industry safe and sound, protect consumers, and foster responsible innovation.
My friends, we're going to do something a little different. If anybody has a quick question for her, and as wide as you can, as you know, generalization rather than what's happening in this particular block or whatever. I've had a very good relationship with our superintendent. She has been forthcoming. She has been a friend to the committee, and I want to make sure that you avail yourself. Does anyone have a question for her?
I don't have a question, but I just have a comment. I've dealt with many state agencies, and the superintendent has been very responsive, and I'm really appreciative of that. Many times we try to get things accomplished, and we can't because we can't get a meeting or we can't get a discussion, and she's kept an open mind and been very helpful to. So I want to thank you for that.
Thank you, sir.
I have a comment as well. DFS and my committee have partnered up in so many different circumstances to do some outreach to the public. You know, we partnered up on student loan debt, and it's just great to have someone like Linda Lacewell head DFS and just watch out for the little guy. I'm so proud of her being an Indian American as well. Just wanted to put that out there.
Sir.
Yeah, I think Ms. Lacewell, superintendent, has done a magnificent job in her position and deserves to be credited for all the work that she's done, the relationship that she's kept with the legislature, and we look forward to working with you.
Thank you.
This committee, is there anyone else? Sir.
Well, just from your point of view, what do you need from us? What's the biggest issue legislatively? I mean, do we repeal some bills or do we have to write some bills? What's the problem that we have to deal with or the issues you think are most important for our leadership here and all of us on the Banking Committee?
Well, I think that helping the consumer is critically important. And I always hesitate when I say that because when you say the consumer, it sounds like some other person, right? There's no consumers over there and we're over here. We're all consumers. So what do I mean? Safety and soundness of our industries is job one. Without the products and services they offer, not only do we not have the jobs and the economic development, but we don't have anything available for consumers to actually protect them and empower them. But the focus that we have at DFS is the impact on people of the decisions that we make. So that's why I say the consumer must be and is at the center of everything we do. Because at the end of every decision, as an individual, a family, a small business, a community. And we cannot leave them out of the equation. In this environment, and I've been perfectly blunt on this, where unfortunately the federal agency that was created to protect consumers is abdicating its responsibilities, it is incumbent upon the states to step up. I believe the legislature in New York is doing that. It's New York's tradition to lead and to set the best practices and the model for others to follow. if the CFPB is not going to protect consumers, we have to protect our own people. And the states have got to step up. And the evolving partnership that we have with the legislature here is vitally important. And what we need are the same tools that the CFPB has and is not using. They have dropped those tools on the floor. Let's pick them up. Let's pick them up. We did it on student loans last year. U.S. Department of Education, Betsy DeVos, not interested in protecting student borrowers, not interested in making sure they understand their rights. And I said in a public address, if she doesn't want to do the job, let the states do it. That's what the legislature with the governor did in last year's budget. Thank you for that support. We now license student loan servicers, and we're going to protect them to the fullest extent of the law. On regular consumer matters, where people are being deceived, the elderly, veterans, people of color, women of color above all, who get preyed upon the most by the bad actors in there. Let's give DFS the tools that it needs to step up and protect people, to protect you, your family, your neighbors, your constituents. What do I mean by that? Right now, in many instances, we have to prove somebody lied before we can go after them on a consumer protection matter. The con men out there, the con people out there, they typically don't lie to your face. They trick you. They deceive you. That's why deceptive practices, misleading practices are supposed to be outlawed. But we have to prove they lied to you, that it was intentional conduct. That doesn't work. If it's an insurance matter, we can't get restitution unless the company agrees in a settlement to give us the restitution. That doesn't work. If it's an unlicensed actor, we cannot go after them as vigorously. When DFS was created, the point was to empower state government to get our markets to be vital and active. And for that to happen, they have to be serving people with integrity, and they themselves, industries, have to be protected against these rogue actors. There should be a level playing field so that good businesses can thrive and so that unlicensed actors are not trying to eat their lunch. So I thank you for the question. And I am focused on making sure that we can protect consumers to the fullest extent of the law. There was a bill that was introduced last year, Senator Comrie, Assemblywoman Wright. And that is our top priority. And it when I talk about the consumer, as I drill down now on who is the consumer that's affected, it is communities of color. Women of color carry more student debt than any other population. They also have trouble paying it back because of pay disparities and the discrimination that unfortunately still thrives. Communities of color are excluded from banking services. That's why the financial inclusion statewide office to be based at DFS is a vitally important priority. Because all people are entitled to participate in our great financial system. And the exclusion of those populations, coupled with the targeting of those populations with the worst financial trash products, to sell them, to burden them, to drive them deeper into debt, which just entrenches decades and generations of discrimination, is not acceptable, least of all in the great state of New York. And we are going to be a stronger state, a stronger economy, and have a more vital future when everyone can participate in our great financial system. So thank you for the question.
Well, is anyone else who wants to put a quick question? Well, let me say this. The committee, of course, has not had time to digest the positions that you have put. But I would suggest that it will be a rare difference that we may have with you. The we'll have to find something to differ with you on. But I'm sure we can muster.
Don't give the Republicans a challenge.
This was chopping at the bits on me.
He's up for any challenge you guys come up with. So, but having said those things, you will find that this is going to be a very listening committee. This is a committee that is interested in engagement. We really want to work. We want to make sure that we have a banking policy from, watch this one, here's where I get in trouble, from the shores of Lake Erie.
Thank you.
To the Finger Lakes, to the wine country, and even to that great and majestic land, the Rockaways, where I am from. So we're going to have a policy that's good for everyone, and I do mean that. We're outside of this room, we're going to be Republican and Democrat and do all kinds of wonderful things. Inside this room, we're really going to focus on what's good for the state of New York. What's good for the people of New York? What do they need? And that's the spirit that we're bringing to you. We appreciate your engagement. And since we couldn't get higher than that, I'm going to ask Mr. Young to lead our superintendent out. Is there any final words that you want to give to us?
No, I just want to say that in doing this vital work, your perspectives are critical because you have deep roots and experience with your communities, your businesses, your industries, and you know what's happening. And you've studied a lot of these issues and pushed a lot of these policy items for a long time. So I mean it. I want to not just be responsive to you, but I want you to seek me out. I want us to talk these things through together so that we're focusing on the right priorities and that we're getting it right. So thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Wait a minute, did you get that one? I told you I'm political. As you can leave now, and if anyone wants to shake their hand and get their picture, I won't stop. Not that I'm putting that out there. My friends, or do you want to attend the meeting? Oh, I like this.
Oh, are we done?
No, you are done, okay. But you are
thank
welcome
you.
To
No.
Stay.
I appreciate it. I'll let you get started.
That's sorry, when you sir. Really enjoy the meeting.
I know you.
Pleasure to see you. That's when you enjoy the committee.
Thank you so much. Thanks for coming. Thank you. Pleasure to see you.
Thank you.
My friends, since everyone gave their name for the record, I won't repeat it again. But I will say this. I was very serious when I was saying that why don't we just try to figure out what's good for the state of New York. What's good, and I mean that from my Republican colleagues and my Democratic colleagues. If we could just figure out what's good, let's do some work on this one. With that, we're going to go quickly through this agenda, and then I think we've done it here. Would you be kind enough to read this to us?
The first bill is Senate Bill 297, sponsored by Senator Giannaris. It's an act to amend the banking law in relation to requiring transmitters of money to provide a certain warning to consumers.
Are there any questions on this bill?
Move the bill.
Second. We move. Did you get that? Move by Kennedy. Move fast here. Move by Kennedy. And second by Prasad had you beat by a split second.
I can always defer to her. Don't worry about it.
The next one is from a very smart guy, I believe. Go ahead.
Senate Bill 2106A by Senator Sanders, an act to amend the banking law in relation to requiring banks to disclose any negative consequences an alternative loan payment schedule may have on credit scores.
Is any common question? Moved by Thomas, second by Kennedy. Any nays? Any without record? Two nays. Don't invite them.
Not personal.
I don't. I truly don't take it personal, my friend. But I couldn't help that. Go to the next one.
Senate Bill 2397 by Senator Comrie. An act to direct the New York State Department of Financial Services and the New York State Department of State's Consumer Protection Division to conduct a study on consumer awareness and financial education in New York State and to make recommendations for consumer awareness and financial education program.
Questions? Motions? Did you get that?
Yes.
Okay. Your last bill, I believe. From who?
Senate Bill 4188 to Senator Kennedy, an act to amend the banking law in relation to requiring financial institutions to notify a customer prior to charging a fee based on account and activity.
Move it.
Second.
Moved and second. I think I'll be a no. Any nays? Any without rec? All right. You got that?
Yes.
Then I want to thank everybody for being here. The next meeting will be shorter. Anybody who wants to meet with me on anything that they want, please meet with me on this type of stuff. Thank you very much for being here. This meeting is officially adjourned. The unofficial one begins.
Yes.
And thank you for taking my advice and being on this committee.
Yes, sir.
I told you this.